Hiyas, welcome back to Sapio SMP, and as you can see, I've been a little busy. That's not my house, that's Hyang's house, who killed me in a dragon fight, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. For now, hi. So, I was a little busy, did a lot of stuff. As you can see, we got an elytra. I fixed up the greenhouse a little bit. I added a bunch of these light gray glass panes, and the thing I love about this is that it gives a more textured feeling to the outside. Before, it was very plain, you could see directly inside, but now you get these little stripes that kind of move. It's very dynamic and it's not flat. Hey spider. Also, there was a trap, a horse trap over there, so I, as anyone would, named one Skelly. Very, very good boy, that horse. Skeleton horse is. But yeah, that's another thing I did. I didn't record some of these things. I did record the dragon fight, the first dragon fight. Yeah, the first dragon fight. And you'll see some of that footage right now as it's rolling. And not a lot of commentary behind it, except, see, we weren't actually in a voice call together, so Hyang didn't know that I was underneath the dragon punching away at it and blew up a bed, so I lost everything again. The things I have now, I had to rebuild from the ground up again, but it's all right. So that was one of the dragon fights. The second dragon fight was much easier. I just went there alone and collected a bunch of dragon's breath because it might be useful. It might come in useful someday. This guy was a zombie villager that I cured, and the first lectern I put down, the guy decided, hey, you basically want free mending books? And I said, heck yeah. So we have, let me show you, a chest full of mending books. Okay, almost a chest full. I also found a strider that I really like. The guy is now mine, and he was a good boy. He helped me find another nether fortress which had nether wards, so we're doing that. I got a bunch of strength 2 potions right there. Slow falling for end busting, which I used after the second dragon fight. The second portal opened up, so I used that. So I collected a bunch of ender chests, a lot of goodies, as well as shulker boxes, which you saw up here. I don't know why I showed you that. But currently, these two are full of stuff that I want to build a shop with. Yes, we are building a shop this episode. And if you remember the rules to my shop, the shopping district, it is that in order to pay for a 9x9 plot of land, you have to use a diamond block. And for me, I'm going to use this diamond block. And the way the paying system works is you come to me, and I'm going to have a little area for this, but don't mind me while I just get a flint and steel. The way you pay for it is you throw the diamond block in front of me, and I to do that. Yep, it's gone now. Here's the thing. The reason why I'm doing that is I don't want to keep the diamond for myself. I think that's unfair. I mean, I do own the server, but that's still pretty unfair. I got a bunch of heads. I need to create a whole different double chest for heads only. That's gonna be fun. Not insane at all. So I have a design in mind. Currently, I'm only going to do mending books, but it's eventually going to be the store to get all of your enchanted books from. And what I'm going to do to mark that the 9x9 area is mine is I'm going to bring a bunch of grass blocks and replace a 9x9 area with grass blocks, to signify that that is my plot of land. So let's head on over to that place real quick. Oh, another thing I did was I yeeted a mountain.
Thank you.
And we're here. So what I want to do is, first of all, that point, by the way, is the origin. Right here, folks, is 00. I know, pretty insane. That plot of land I want to buy way later on. I'm going to make this bit my area, my 9x9 area. And the reason why is it's very close to the portal. And by the way, this time, I do have a design in mind. I actually planned ahead. Get out of here. I'm gonna keep the price at a nice little diamond per book. So phantom shouldn't be spawning. There should be no mob spawning around here. I made sure there would be no mobs spawning anywhere. There were some parts of the island that were cold ocean, not mushroom biome or mushroom shore, which was a bit problematic considering mobs can spawn there. And we don't want any mobs spawning around here. That's just facts. And this is going to be a pretty simple build, an 8x8 build, which I actually kind of wanted to do a 16x16 build, but I thought that was a bit overkill for now. So we're going to go with an 8x8. I don't even have that much stock just yet, so we'll cross that bridge when it comes. But for now, I'll show you what the build looks like after a third-person time-lapse. Lantern here, and a lantern here. Oh, and we need a door. Nope, we don't want that. There we go, and we'll name this. And there's a zombified piglin over there. Dude, I get you. You don't want to be in the nether. That's fine. But man, don't come out here. You're not even supposed to be able to spawn on the nether roof. Why are you here? Get out of here. Sorry you had to see that. I guess we can call this Farm and Royal Bookstore. It's definitely not taken from any other bookstore. In Korean, let's call this 동서점 남북. Yes. 동서점 남북. All right. So let's paint that purple. For magic. Oh, by the way, I started out with a stack of each, so just by doing basic subtraction, you should be able to figure out how many colored glass that I used. And I modeled the whole color scheme after the bookshelves themselves. I think this is really nice. So inside, you can see there are barrels. I also decorated with a Fletcher's table here in order to give like an empty shelf kind of vibe. The barrels are going to contain the stock, and I also doubled down. I saw this trick on Reddit on the ladders, I mean, with barrels, so that it's a little more three-dimensional than just the flatness that is the ladder. So I think this is a really interesting looking build. I'm quite satisfied with it. No reason to light up the top either, because, well, I mean, it's mushroom biome. Nothing's gonna spawn here. So anyways, let's get this place stocked. One book equals one diamond. And we're just gonna go with the old trust system. I'm gonna stock this place up with probably the mending's gonna be here, the unbreaking is going to be here, maybe sharpness 5 over here, use all the villagers that we have, and I think we're also going to start making a villager trading hall in the next episode. I have a place that I have scouted out. It is the floating island, by the way, and we already have a cured zombie villager, one of them, so I think that's going to be great. Let's just put a torch here just to light up the place a little bit. I know it's Mushroom Island and things can't spawn, but we still want things to be a little more brighter. That's our build for today. That's our big build for today. So let's go back home and let me introduce you to some other stuff. All right, so the rest of the plan for this episode is to just introduce you to some of the things I have in mind for now. Here is going to be a barn. It's going to be a nice little barn. It's going to be about this tall and then have a roof that goes around like this, kind of matching the height of this build. Here, I moved the nether portal up just a little bit, if you can't tell. It was originally right here up against the edge. I put it here so that I can cover it up with a small grayscale build. That's going to be a lighthouse. The mountain that I yeeted was over here, as you can see. There's a huge basin. I think I'm going to turn that into a port. So that's going to be interesting because the port is going to have a house, a little shed. And it's going to start out as a wooden shed. And then it's going to turn into a grayscale shed. So let me give you a bit of an idea of how that's going to work. And look how that blends. It doesn't blend at all. And that's the point. See, below here, that's supposed to be, you know, colorful. But then grayscale happens for some reason from level 2 on. And I have to change this. I have to terraform that. One of the reasons why I yeeted the whole mountain was because I thought that would be much easier than terraforming it. But here we are. Turns out that was not the case. That's the general idea. This is going to be probably either a build I do in between this episode and the next, or a build I plan and then do in the next episode. This looks surreal. I really like this. The whole border that's happening here. Yeah, that is interesting. Especially when you're just on the right height. And I'll freeze the frame at exactly the right moment in post. For now, I think that's the plan over there. I think I'm gonna build another house over here just to match the scale of this one. Okay, some rest of the plans. The buildings are gonna slowly rise up in height. I think I'm going to have to yeet this mountain as well. I didn't really want to, but I think it might have to be that way because there is a big skyscraper coming this way. A huge one. It's gonna act as the mob grinder, but that means the building itself is probably gonna go up to about the height limit. But for now, I'm going to have to do a lot more resource gathering. It's gonna be easier now that I have the elytra and the shulker boxes, but for now I'm gonna call that an episode, and probably next episode will be the lighthouse. Hopefully, we'll see what occurs. Oh, also, I'm probably gonna put an observatory up there. It's gonna be a nice little watchtower that looks down at the city, looks up at the stars. It's gonna be beautiful. It's gonna be a nice. That's going to be the tourist attraction right over there. But that's a lot of dirt. The future me will take care of it. Whatever. Where's the C button? Whatever. That's a lot of ice. I can harvest that. Anyways, that's it for this episode. Thank you for watching till the very end. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.